Manavala Mamurigal instructs Hastagiriyanna, you do something by which Srinivasa's glory will be celebrated everywhere. So because of this, the Lord's beauty, Lord's knowledge, Lord's understanding, everybody will get to know. So there was one devotee who was in a Sri Vaishnava Pillai Lokacharya family. He was in their descendant. He was a great devotee of Lord Varadaraja, and he prayed to the Lord when he got married, and they had a son whom they named as Hastagiri Anna. Hastagiri is Lord is the name of Lord Varadaraja. In the mercy of the Lord, because this boy was born, he was named Hastagiri Anna. His name was Hastagiri Anna. From his childhood, a very sincere boy, very pious, very spiritual, because coming in a great lineage, he was sent to school of Swami Nayana Varadacha, who was also a great descendant of Vedanta Desika. So he was sent unto him to understand about all the intricacies of Vaishnava philosophy. So this boy had joined there, and very soon he was picking up all the essential parts of the philosophy. So he was very much easy to, and very much putting questions, trying to learn all these things about spiritual life and Vaishnava principles. Very sadhu, very gentle, and very shuddha sattvaguna he was exhibiting. So he became very dear to all the acharyas and all the other friends also because of his behavior. So one day in that place there was Shankaracharya disciple whose name was Narasimha Mishra, who had come there. So he was on a tour going everywhere, defeating Vaishnava philosophy and trying to convert them into his Advaita philosophy. So when he was traveling, he came to Kanchipuram and he was calling various people for a debate. The point in the debate is, if the person whoever loses had to surrender himself with all his disciples to the person whoever is winning, and he should follow their philosophy. So this is the bet. Many people he had already defeated there. Now finally he had given offer to Swami Nayanachar. So Nayanachar was also trying to avoid what to do, this unnecessary wasting time with these people. Mayavadi Bhasha Sunilaya Hai Sarvanash, we all know with this philosophy. So he was trying to avoid the situation. But date is tomorrow is the last day he had to approach. He had to do a debate, or else either debate or accept defeat. This is how the situation is. The Guru was becoming very much disturbed. He was very sad. Seeing the sadness of his Guru, the small boy Anna, he wanted to satisfy his Guru. So he went to his other disciples and asked, what is that reason why our Guru is not happy, why he is very sad? Then the other disciples explained to him, there is one Narasimha Mishra here, a Mayavadi sannyasi who has come here and he has challenged our Guru. So then this boy said, okay, I will go and debate that person. So he goes to Guru and seeks his blessing. He says, please bless me that I will go on your behalf and debate that Advaita sannyasi. The Guru also very much satisfied, blessed him with Hayagriva mantra and said, all glories unto you, you will be very successful, proceed. So when this boy entered the arena, there were many people assembled there. Many scholars had come there, some to hear, some to visualize, some to debate. So different categories of people were, and some general people were also there. So when they saw this small boy, the Narasimha Mishra, he was thinking, what is this small boy? I can crush big elephants. He's like an ant. I'll finish him off him in no time. Then the boy was also seeing the arrogant attitude, arrogant voice of Narasimha Mishra, and he was thinking, because of his arrogance is the cause of one's fall down. He was thinking, just moments, how long will your arrogance will stay? How long your prideness will stay? Just for a moment, wait, I will show you what is real life. So then both of them sat. Then this boy said, don't take me, don't go by my age and by my size. Ask all your questions, what you are ready for. Ready to answer. So then Mishra started. He started, I'll ask you some basic questions. And he started asking. The way this boy started narrating, it was so good, so melodious, so perfect to the conclusions, with quoting references from various shastras. Narasimha Mishra was dumbfounded. All the other people were astonished. This was like the same scene what they had heard 100 years before, when Yamunacharya had a debate when he was a child. All of them remembered the same situation, like this child competing with a great scholar. So in the meantime, some of the followers, the friends, disciples of Acharya, went back and informed Nayanachar, sir, see how your disciple is progressing, how he is able to defeat Advaitin. So Nayanacharya also slowly walked and came. He also saw the glories of his disciple, how gloriously he is establishing the Vaishnava principles. me into your system and please enlighten me in the principles of Vaishnavism. So from that day, this boy became very famous. So Nayanachar blessed Anna by saying, from today, your name is Prativadi Bhayankara. Whenever somebody comes to argue with you are Bhayankara. So this was the title given to him. And he was given the in charge of worshipping the Mata and the deity of Varadaraja, because they are in the parampara. The Varadaraja deity was worshipped by their Acharya. So he was given the in charge to take care of worship of Varadaraja. So he did nicely served Varadaraja. After few years of serving Varadaraja, once he was reading Nammalvar's description of Lord Srinivasa from Tiruvanmoyil. So when he heard the beautiful description of Srinivasa, he wanted to go to Tirupati and do some service to Srinivasa there. So taking permission from Lord Varadaraja, he went to Tirupati. So there, in the association of Anant Alvar's descendants, he was engaging in service of Lord Srinivasa. So his duty was every day to pick up water from Akashaganga and bring it for Lord's offering. You have to add some spices, make it fragrant water. Padya, Argya, Ashmaniya, when you want to offer, then spices have to be mixed into that water. So every day he had to carry water from Akashaganga and he had to deliver into the temple by mixing these spices. So he was doing his duty nicely. One day, he came across one more devotee from Srirangam, who was a disciple of Manavala Mamuni. So they started describing about Manavala Mamuni and Sangh. They were lost in the descriptions. The glories of Manavala Mamuni were being described, and Anna forgot about his duty that he was supposed to deliver water. And offering time was ready. Without water, the pujaris were in tension. So they came running to the place where this discussion was happening, snatched the pots from him and went away to the temple. And they started doing the offerings because it was becoming delayed. Then Anna realized that he had not mixed the water, and he ran towards the temple to inform that the water is not ready to be offered to the Lord. But by the time he went, already water offering has started and it was about to finish. The rituals were about to finish. And in the last moment, he was feeling very sad, standing in front of the Lord and begging forgiveness. Please forgive me. Today there is an aparadha happened in myself, that I am not able to do my duty properly, that I am not able to offer properly the water what was supposed to you as per the standard. And he was begging forgiveness repeatedly from the Lord. And when he was begging in that forgiveness mode, at that time he heard one voice, Supreme Lord Srinivasa speaking himself. He started saying, today is the best water I had tasted. Today that water was so fragrant, never ever in my life tasted such a pure nectar. Then he was contemplating, what made the water fragrant? Then he understood, discussions about devotee, great devotees, made that water fragrant, where Lord is saying, I enjoyed that water. Then he understood, took permission from Lord Srinivasa to go and meet that devotee, Manavala Mamunigal, who was staying in Srirangam, and he wanted to learn more intricate subjects of Vaishnava philosophy. So taking permission from Srinivasa, he came to Srirangam, had darshan of the Lord, Ranganatha, then went to the Swamiji, where Acharya was giving lecture like this. He sat in that lecture and he was immersed into that lecture. He was engrossed. After the lecture was over, so Swamiji was calling all the disciples forward. So he was able to identify Anna and asked him to come forward. So Anna came forward and paid obeisances. At the time, Swamiji, he was saying, you are that Prativada Bhayankara. I know your title. You are that Bhayankara person. And he said, no, sir. I am only Prativada Bhayankara for opponents. For Vaishnavas, I am Dasanu Dasa, he says. By seeing his sincerity and the Vaishnava etiquette, then Acharya trains him all the knowledge and he gives him the title, from today you are Sri Vaishnava Dasa. So taking again mercy of this Acharya, after learning from him, he goes back to Tirumala. He starts resuming his service to Lord Srinivasa. So after a few days, Manavala Mamunigal also approaches Tirupati, and there both of them were serving the Lord. So at that time, Hastagiri Anna, you do something by which Srinivasa's glory will be celebrated everywhere. So because of this, the Lord's beauty, Lord's knowledge, Lord's understanding, everybody will get to know. So with his inspiration, the Suprabhatam was compiled for Srinivasa. And that Suprabhatam was so glorious, it was of various compositions. It had 4 parts in that Suprabhatam. There were 29 verses, 11 Stotrams, 16 Prapatti and 14 Mangala Shashana verses. Suprabhatam consists of this 4-fold. like 29 verses to wake up the Lord and Lakshmi Devi, first 29 verses. Then in next 11 stotrams, they glorify the Lord. Next 16 verses, a devotee offers surrender to the Lord. And in the last 14 verses, he describes auspiciousness by describing the Lord. He glorified these verses and became so good that Manavala Mami, he instructed all his disciples, from today, this Suprabhata should be recited in all our Vaishnava temples every day.